Hello! Hello! Good afternoon po sa inyong lahat. Well, andito na naman ako. This is your tita, Tita Elin. Some call me Doktora. So ako po si Doktora Elinor T Roquel. No? So, now, while I'm waiting for Patrick to come, kasi pupunta kami kay Father Alex in a short while for the Mass, kasi it's a Sunday, it's January 2, sabi ko, might as well gawin na natin yung ating daily reading, no? So, eto siya. Binatin. Okay, ha? January 2. Seeking what God is giving. So, the Lord gives wisdom. From His mouth comes knowledge and understanding. Proverbs chapter 2, verse 6. In the book, sabi, perhaps as the first day of the year, of the new year passed, certain questions are still in your mind that you just cannot shake. Issues that have long troubled you persist in causing your faith to waver. You wonder when or if God will ever help you. You most likely have sought the Father before about these burdens, which is the very best thing you can do. But don't approach Him just to talk about the problem. He already understands all this, and He knows about them and doesn't benefit from your assessment. Instead, go before Him to listen. Remember that the fear of the Lord, the acknowledgement of Him as God, is the beginning of wisdom, and He freely gives knowledge and understanding to those who will wholeheartedly recognize that He holds the answer. In fact, Jesus promised, "Keep on asking and you will receive what you ask for. Keep on seeking and you will find. Keep on knocking and the door will be opened to you." Matthew 7:7. This is a guarantee from God Himself. The Father wants to help you understand. He longs to show you what He is achieving through that situation, what He desires for you to learn from it, and how you can achieve the victory in it. So the wisest thing you can do is continue getting on your face before Him in prayer, opening His Word, and giving His Holy Spirit ample time to speak to you. Keep seeking. Do not lose heart. The Lord will give you the wisdom you need to triumph in all your facing. And then towards the end of the page, there is a prayer that says, Father, you know the questions that continue on my heart. I come before you to listen, Lord, knowing you have the answer to every need and the wisdom to guide me in every situation. Amen. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Ang ganda na naman. So kahapon, ang title nung page 1 is beginning. Pagkatapos sabi niya, ang beginning is the fear of the Lord is the beginning and the preeminent part of knowledge. So, at ang sabi pa, ang beginning daw ng taon natin should be assured. Ang magsisimula ay ang Diyos. So that there will be clarity and purpose all throughout the year. Diba ang ganda? Now, on day 2, January 2, sabi niya, seeking what God is giving. And God is giving us wisdom. When I was working, year 2000, I was working as one of the medical consultant for Herb Care Charantia, and the person who guided me is HMA. We call him Mr. Abelarde. Hi, sir. Good afternoon. I hope you see me now and keep healthy. Hello, Ma'am Sally. So sabi niya sa akin, Doktora, alam mo, ikaw full of wisdom ka. Sabi ko, oh, talaga po, salamat naman. Sabi ko, so in my heart, ano nga ba yung ibig sabihin ng wisdom? And without even asking Sir Lito, Mr. Abelarde, he said, alam mo ba ibig sabihin ng wisdom, Doktora? You cannot find it in the books. You cannot learn it from school. It's in your heart. It comes with all, with knowing what is good and what is bad, what is right from what is wrong, and continue to doing things that is good and that is right. So, how do we come to know about what is good and what is right? January reading from yesterday tells us that number one is takot sa Diyos, fear of the Lord. Because if you have fear of the Lord, you will not do anything na makakagalit sa Kanya, makakasakit sa Kanya. And in doing so, hindi ka gagawa ng anything na makakasakit sa kapwa mo. So, siguro, I was just very, very lucky to have a mother, my mom, na from the very beginning when we were still young, during the time that we were learning to read, ang pinaka-favorite na binabasa namin ay, come to think of it, the Holy Bible. So, bata pa lang ako, nagbabasa na po ako ng Bible. And these things are no longer new to me because as I grow older, I finally realize na, oh nga no, everything is rooted from the Lord, from the author of life. So, yon. So, ngayon, seek what He is giving. And the Lord gives wisdom. Because when you know what is good and what is right, and you do those things that are good and pleasing to the eyes of God, alam mo, everything will follow. You may not be the wealthiest, the most successful, the most beautiful person on earth, but you are happy and satisfied because you know na masaya ka in your heart. Tapos sabi pa dito, yung pinaka gusto natin, Hi, Onet! I love you, Onet! I miss you, Onet. Ayan po si Miss Onet Gregorio. Is one of the few people na merong value ng patience, compassion, humility, gentleness. Ayan po ang tao na kapag tinusok ka ng needle, hindi masakit. Kasi ginagawa niya lahat yung paraan para hindi ka masaktan. Hi, Onet. I miss you. Sa susunod na bakuna ko, ikaw ang magbibigay. Ha, ma'am? Okay. So, sabi pa dito, keep on seeking and you will find. Keep on knocking and the door will be open to you. Keep on asking and it will be given you. That's Matthew 7:7. One of our very, very useful verses. Sige lang, ulit-ulitin mo lang yung mga prayers mo. It will come to happen. No? In God's perfect timing. Sige lang, hanapin mo lang, sabihin mo lang every day. So, I guess that's it. Medyo mahaba itong aking sharing ngayon. Now, the second part of my sharing is Yerba Buena. Remember, yes, last night, no? Last night, ishinare ko sa inyo how to use the Yerba Buena oil. Nakuno lang to siya. Kinuha ko siya sa garden. Kasi I have a garden dito sa bahay and I plant this yerba buena. Ayan po ang yerba buena. It's a mint. Pakita. Yan. Madali lang siyang itanim. Puputulin mo siya from the mature stem and then lagay mo lang siya sa water for overnight and then the following day, tanim mo na siya dun sa lupa. Mabango siya. And during the time na dinidiligan mo, mabango siya. Now, sa DOH Petak, long time ago, they are distributing this book for free. Now, on one page, says, Yerba Buena. So, according to DOH Petak, Yerba Buena is good sa pananakit ng iba't ibang bahagi ng katawan. So, sabi niya, pwede daw itong kumuha sa umaga, pagkatapos ugasan, pagkatapos ay tawag nito, ilaga, pagkatapos ay inumin. Sarap na tea, ginagawa ko rin yan. And then, sabi pa niya, pwede daw idikdikin ang sariwang dahon at itapas sa bahagi na nananakit. So, ano yung mangyayari? So, what we hope for is, of course, natanggal yung pananakit ng bahagi ng katawan na yon. So, I have several experiences with using this as a tea. So, kumukuha ako ng kalahating tasa ng dahon ng yerbabuena. Kasi pag malagong-malago na to, masyado itong marami eh. And then I wash it, and then I boil it for 2-3 minutes or even shorter. Or even boiling water lang on a pot of fresh leaves. And then, mga after 3-5 minutes, iniinom ko na siya. Ang effect naman is, pumasakit ang ulo mo, nawawala yung sakit ng ulo mo, and then nakaka-relax siya. Kapag noong araw, pag may dysmenorrhea, iinom din ako niyan in tea form, and nakakatulong siya. But of course, I have to take other medications kasi tsaa lang naman yun eh. So, imagine kung sa simpleng tsaa ng yerbabuena, nakakatulong na sa pag-alleviate o pagtanggal o pag-alis ng mga sakit-sakit natin sa katawan. How much more kung mayroong makakaisip na gawin itong gamot? Diba? So, that's it for today. I hope meron ulit akong na ibahagi sa inyo, and I hope nagustuhan ninyo. See you again tomorrow for January 3 reading, and let me see kung ano naman ang mga natural things na pwede kong i-share sa inyo. We'll come into the medical things, no? Sa mga susunod, magkoconsult tayo, why not, no? Pero for now, I want you to learn natural is better. You know why? Because natural, andyan lang yan. It grows, it ages with us, it heals us, it's God-given, it's not adulterated, and it's effective. So that's it, guys. Thank you so much. Ma'am Lion Evelyn Dasco, roar. Hello, ma'am. Good afternoon. And then to all my friends who's viewing, naging bibigay ng hearts and thumbs up, maraming salamat sa inyo. Hi, Roquel. Hi, Miss Roquel Blanco. Kamusta ka na dyan? Happy New Year sa inyo. Have a healthy, happy, happy New Year. Good day. See you soon. Tomorrow again. Bye-bye.